Hello, I'm Jeff Cavins, and today we're looking at the scriptures for the fourth Sunday in Lent. What is wrong with you? How many times have we heard that, either growing up or perhaps even into our adulthood? What is wrong with you? Why are you like that? Why are you doing this or that? Well, most likely you know what is wrong with you. We all have some sense of inadequacy. We have all a sense of a weakness in our life that maybe people know about, maybe they don't know about, but we think about it a lot. I wish I could be like that guy. I wish I could be like that lady. But we are living with our weaknesses. In the gospel reading today, that's the topic. And we see that it says in John chapter 9, as he passed by, he saw a man blind from his birth. And his disciples asked him, "Rabbi, who sinned, this man or his parents, that he was born blind?" The disciples, like us, are always looking for some kind of explanation as to, why am I like this? Like we're supposed to be born absolutely perfect. Listen to Jesus' answer. Jesus said, "It was not that this man sinned or his parents, but that the works of God might be made manifest in him." My friends, this is a game changer. As we take our weaknesses to the Lord, we realize that it is in the midst of weaknesses, or we could call it inadequacies, that God shows his strength. Over and over, we see this in the life of Paul. We see this in the life of Peter, where God comes into a place of weakness and he makes us strong. The place of our weakness or our inadequacy is actually a stage on which God can demonstrate his mercy and demonstrate his powerful, powerful presence. But the key is that we must yield to him and allow him to do the work in our life. Now, what's interesting about this reading in John chapter 9 is where it takes place. It takes place at a pool called Siloam. Let me continue to read. Jesus said, "We must work the works of him who sent me while it is day. Night comes when no one can work. As long as I am in the world, I am the light of the world." As he said this, he spat on the ground and made clay of the spittle and anointed the man's eyes with the clay, saying to him, "Go wash in the pool of Siloam," which means sent. Now here's what's interesting about that. The pool of Siloam is at the southern edge of the city of David. In 2 Samuel chapter 5, we see that there's a water shaft that was key to David taking the city of Jerusalem from the Jebusites. And as he was about to take Jerusalem, the king of the Jebusites taunted David and he said, "Even the blind and the lame can defeat you in this city." Well, that wasn't true because David took Jerusalem. But isn't it interesting that 1,000 years later, the son of David is at this pool of Siloam facing a blind man. And it's the power of God that overcomes the weakness of this man, the so-called inadequacy in his life, and God shows himself strong. The name of the pool, Siloam, it means sent. And one of the lessons that we can learn from this is that after we submit our weaknesses to the Lord, and he demonstrates his strength through our weaknesses, we become those who are sent. The ones that are sent to the world to tell them what Jesus has done. My friend, I want to encourage you today. I want to encourage you today as you contemplate the weaknesses in your life. You can run, you can hide, you can self-medicate, you can deny. But the best thing to do with the weaknesses in our life is to submit them to Jesus and ask him to do an amazing work in our life. You know, as I grew up, I sensed a strong inadequacy in my own life. I didn't want to talk in front of people. I didn't like the way I looked. I wet my pants in my bed until I was in eighth grade, and I just didn't want to stand in front of people. I wondered, what would God do with me? But you know, as I submitted that weakness to God, he was able to fill that with his strength, and he was able to do something with a weak person. Why did I have those inadequacies? Why did I have those weaknesses? That God would show himself strong and the works of God would be demonstrated in my life. This week, what I'd like you to do is to take some time and think about those areas that you hide from, you deny, or you run from or self-medicate over. And I'd like you to take those to prayer. Take them to Jesus and say, "Jesus, I have always felt weak and inadequate in these particular areas. Lord, I now give them to you. And Lord, demonstrate your strength in my life and use this to bring others to you. Lord, touch my life. I know I'm sent, and I will go and I will proclaim your glory.